Hi guys, I have with me Dhananjay. Dhananjay is a dear friend. We know each other for almost 4 years now, right?
Yes.
And I hold him in high regards. So he is in 8 times Microsoft MVP.
Yes.
And all those 8 years are consecutive years, right?
Yes.
Right. So 8 times consecutive MVP, and you are also the MVP this time also, Microsoft MVP.
Yes.
Right. So that's a great thing. And besides being an MVP, he has authored about 1,000 articles. He has conducted about 60 workshops, and most of them free of cost.
Yes.
All those technical workshops. He has been a conference speaker. So in India, it is like you think of AngularJS. You will be, the name of the AngularJS teacher is Dhananjay. Teacher may be a wrong word. Trainer may be right.
Right.
That's right. So in this video, that conversation will be specific to Microsoft MVP in particular and MVP in general. What does it take to be an MVP? And by MVP, I mean most valued professional. Right. So what does it take to be an MVP? Who are the MVPs? What is the kind of effort that goes in to become an MVP? And what is the value addition that it will have in your career or maybe in personality? Right. So first of all, you want to talk about what is Microsoft MVP, and what is it that means that we should infer from when we say that this particular person is an MVP.
So great. So Microsoft MVP is it stands for most valuable professional,
mm-hmm.
and it is a kind of award Microsoft gives you.
Mm-hmm.
So just to start with, this is not a place which you pass.
Mm-hmm.
This is a recognition by Microsoft,
mm-hmm.
For your work.
Right.
And I'm going to detail what are those works.
Mm-hmm.
And this is an award which mainly they give to 100 people in India,
mm-hmm.
and around 4,000 people all across the world.
And this number is fixed.
So it's not like hard fixed.
Okay.
It varies.
Almost.
But
okay.
Almost this is.
So it remains around 100 in India.
100, 110 kind of, yes.
Yeah. So who are these people? So how does Microsoft choose that, these are the 100 people whom I will be giving MVP?
Okay, so if you go through the tagline of Microsoft MVP,
mm-hmm.
it says independent expert,
mm-hmm.
and real-time answers.
Okay.
So if real-time answers.
Okay.
So if you are an independent expert, so many people get this confusion that Microsoft MVP means you work for Microsoft.
Okay.
No, you are an independent professional,
mm-hmm.
and what Microsoft recognizes that besides your work, you are working in an organization, you are doing your day job, but besides that, if you are helping other developers,
mm-hmm.
and that help could be in any form,
mm-hmm.
you can help a developer by writing articles,
right.
Publishing them free of cost online,
mm-hmm.
or you can help a developer by answering questions on Stack Overflow,
mm-hmm.
or you may create an open source project or can contribute to already existing
mm-hmm.
open source project, or first you can conduct free workshop.
Right. So if I am a developer, I am helping other developers, and how does Microsoft recognize me? How does Microsoft come to me? Suppose 90% of my help is offline, right? I am not so much visible online. I am not helping people on Stack Overflow maybe, but I am helping them by conducting seminars, and those seminars, I am not posting those seminars online. So how should I make myself visible to Microsoft, or how will Microsoft discover me?
Okay. So this is a two-way process, okay? Very first, if you are doing only offline activity, like you don't have any online persona, what does it mean that you don't write articles, you don't write books, you don't answer questions on forums, and you don't have any online activity, but you are highly active in offline activities, like you go to colleges and educate students or anything of such matter. Microsoft, it is tough for Microsoft to discover. It's like the community program.
Mm-hmm.
So someone is from MVP, existing MVP community, or someone from Microsoft,
mm-hmm.
should be aware of this, that you are doing this.
Mm-hmm.
And then what they will do, that they will nominate you.
Okay. So it is a recommendation kind of
thing. It's a recommendation, not exactly. So this, it was only like someone should recommend you.
Mm-hmm.
Now if you think that you deserve Microsoft MVP,
mm-hmm.
you can self-nominate yourself.
Okay.
So you can go to mvp.microsoft.com
and say that, you know, I deserve this MVP, so I should be getting this because this is my body of work.
Then there's a form which
right.
you have to fill, and then that will go to corresponding country MVP lead, and then his job or her job starts.
Mm-hmm.
He'll go and evaluate.
Right. So he will actually evaluate whether this is a genuine case or not so genuine case.
Yeah, so this is, if I tell you, this is whether a person gets Microsoft MVP or not, is not in the hand of one person.
Okay.
So actually you get Microsoft MVP in a specific product category.
Okay. So and what are those categories?
There are many, but to name a few, you have .NET, open source development.
Yeah.
They call it Visual Studio Development. So
yeah.
if you're having a lot of .NET or Angular or JavaScript, all those developer related thing, then you may go to that category.
Okay.
If you are doing a lot of work on cloud, you may go to Azure category.
Okay.
If recently you are working on machine learning, AI, natural language processing, then you may go to machine and AI category.
Right.
And then
but all of them are technical categories, right? There is no non-technical category where we say that.
No, so there is no non-technical category. It's purely it's your technical contribution which they
and what is the duration for which this work is considered? Is it like 1 year last 1 year duration, or is it like the entire body of work?
Okay, so when you get it first time, you go and create your profile as impressive as you want. You can put your 3 years work. You can put, so let us say if you are just writing book, you can say that, hey, I have written 5 books in last 6 years.
Okay.
They may consider that, right?
Okay.
So first time there is no hard rule than what they consider.
Mm-hmm.
But once you are a MVP, and then for this award is valid for 1 year.
Okay.
Then for the next time they are going.
They will only consider that last year. Last year, because the previous year's contribution has already been considered.
That's great.
So you know, is it like that? Microsoft will only consider people who are promoting or using or in a way. In a way talking about their own technology, or is it across the technology stack?
Okay, so this is a very good question, and I'm a perfect example of that.
Mm-hmm.
For last 3 years, I have been doing JavaScript and Angular.
Okay.
And
right.
neither JavaScript nor Angular
is
are product of
Microsoft
mm-hmm. right? And I have been getting
Microsoft
MVP a lot. So now they have a category called open source.
Okay.
So even if you are doing, you have a very awesome PhD open source project, you can get Microsoft MVP.
But it has to be related to either Microsoft technologies or open source technologies.
Yes.
It cannot be related to proprietary technology of some other company, which is not open source.
Yes, like for example, if you are doing a lot of Salesforce or SAP,
right.
you can get Microsoft MVP for
that. That makes sense.
Yes.
You know? So that makes it clear, right? So, the next thing that probably I want to ask is that, does it require philanthropic work, or can I be giving paid conferences, can I be giving paid seminars? So, my job is that I am a paid trainer of some technology that Microsoft considers, right? So, can I be, am I eligible for that MVP?
So, this is a very tricky question.
Mm-hmm.
It depends on the product you have, in which particular product you are applying, right?
Okay.
So for example, like if they have 1,000 nominations in a particular product category, and they have only 100 seats for that category,
right.
then for sure they will only consider people who are doing for free for the people.
Right.
But
right.
I give you a very good example of this.
Mm-hmm.
If you are a trainer, and that is your bread and butter,
right.
so go and do training, get your dollar.
Mm-hmm. So, is it that it will help you getting a job at Microsoft, or is it completely unrelated, or is it considered, does it hold any point while you are getting an interview for Microsoft, or is it just not related?
Okay, so It depends, okay?
Mm-hmm.
So for example, if I am, one of the main, I'd say feature of MBP program is that, or advantage of MBP program is that you get to work with product team very closely, even
right.
though you are not part
right.
of the
right. right.
So for example, let us consider Azure AI product,
mm-hmm.
right? And right now I am MBP on that and
mm-hmm.
I'm working very closely on that.
Mm-hmm.
And product team feels that this guy should come on board
right, right.
full time.
Right.
So in that case,
so, anyway, you are getting the exposure, right? That is fine.
Mm-hmm.
But I am saying that, you know, will this MVP tag per se, is this tag a value that will be considered in the interview?
It,
or, you know,
it
that
can
is
get
like,
you interview.
That is like an
interview.
That is like an indirect value, right?
It can get you an interview.
Okay.
But this does not have a point that if you are Microsoft MVP,
right, right.
then everyone else is giving 6 rounds of interview,
right.
you've got to go through only 5 rounds of interview.
It can give you
an interview call.
So obviously when you give trainings, then you know your methodical learning about that technology increases. That is an obvious value. Your networking also increases. You know, you get to interact with so many people from that technology. So that will have a huge indirect benefit.
Right.
Right? So probably what you are saying is that it does not have a direct benefit in the sense that, but these are big indirect benefits. So it is not that they do not have a value. Right?
Yes.
So they are big indirect benefits.
And I tell you, I tell you something very interesting.
Yeah.
Like out of 4,000 Microsoft MVP, 3,500 may not want to go and work for Microsoft. They are like making more money than the employees. They are that, you know, real-time expert, independent expert and real-time answer. So they maybe they will go that high-end costly trainers or consulting. So it's Microsoft MVP program is actually not Microsoft student partner program.
Right.
It's an award which gives to an independent, they give it to an independent expert, right?
Right.
So
right.
that's the tagline.
Right.
So if you are aspired to get a job in Microsoft, then MVP is not a part. You go into some of your algorithms
and then probably you should not be investing that 1 year in this particular thing.
Yes.
For this particular thing.
Exactly.
Right?
Yeah.
That makes sense. So what does it take? You know, before getting an MVP, suppose I want to nominate myself for MVP 2018 or maybe 19, whatever comes next, right? What is it that I should do in this year that will help me become an MVP after 1 year?
Okay, so very first, I am Microsoft MVP since 2010.
Mm-hmm.
And when I became Microsoft MVP first time, I was just like 1.5 years old after my college.
Okay, so you have just 1.5 years.
I have 2 years of experience when I got Microsoft MVP.
So that means that, you know, being experienced or not so experienced makes a little difference.
Again, it depends on which product you are targeting.
Okay.
So let us say I am targeting a product which is a young product.
Okay.
Like Azure AI, for example.
Mm-hmm.
Then of course, no one can have 10 years of experience in Azure AI.
Right.
So I'm exactly the same with anyone else. And
mm-hmm.
if I'm working more than them, I'll get.
Mm-hmm.
But if I'm targeting, let us say, H3.com.
Mm-hmm.
Then experience comes to that X. So it depends on the product which you
have. But even as your body of work may be just 1 year. The product may be older, but if your body of work is just 1 year, in this 1 year you have contributed a lot.
Mm-hmm.
Right? Suppose I'm a student of first year.
Mm-hmm.
Right? Can I still get an MVP if I show a body of work of 1 year and that, you know,
okay,
and
so
my contribution?
As best of my knowledge, they don't give MVP award to students.
Okay.
As best of my knowledge, but we can recheck it on internet.
Right.
For students, they have another program called Microsoft Student Partner
Program.
Okay. So they don't give it to a student.
So let's say that, you know, I have 1 year experience.
Mm-hmm.
Right? I have 1 year experience developer and I want to get an MVP. Right?
Mm-hmm.
I'm just fresh out of college. I want to be an MVP. So how should I spend my 1 year?
Okay, so that's what I was saying, that very first, your experience does not matter.
Okay.
You may get in 1 year of experience as well. I got in 1 year, 6 months of experience, right?
Yeah.
Very first, it's an award, so don't count it.
That's right.
It's not an exam that you cover these levels,
right.
You cover these levels.
So it is like creating a movie for the Oscars, right?
Yeah,
so most probably it will fail.
Right? Because
you are not creating it for audience, so if you don't create it for audience, then
because maybe let us say you planned to get MVP awarded open source category.
Right.
And the time you are reaching there, open source category does not have budget to make you MVP.
Right, right.
And they have stopped it for 6 months.
Right, right.
You know, it depends on many, many factors. Mm-hmm. What I say that if you really want to do one of these things, like you want, you love writing articles,
mm-hmm.
or you love answering questions on forums like Stack Overflow,
mm-hmm.
or you love to teach, like you go and teach people offline,
right.
or you are writing books, these are
right.
the four categories, right?
Mm-hmm.
Or contributing to open source. So
right.
in these five categories, if any one of these categories really
mm-hmm.
excite you,
mm-hmm.
you just keep doing that.
Right. And after a year, whenever the nominations are open, just see if...
Nominations are open each day, each year.
Okay, so across the year.
So they give this award, they can give award to new person, like new award.
Mm-hmm.
Of, they give it to first of each month.
First of each month.
So they announce new
right.
people getting this award, first of each
month.
So
it's not a one-off.
Yeah, you don't have to plan
right.
that on that particular day only I'll get.
Mm-hmm.
But for example,
mm-hmm.
If you are writing only articles, right?
Right.
And you are thinking that in 1 year I should get,
mm-hmm.
then you may have to write like 100 articles.
Mm-hmm.
It is like a lot of work.
Right.
Sometimes you combine that, like you write 30 articles, you do 10 workshops.
So about this article thing, you know, what if, you know, I am a shrewd guy, right? And I have a lot of money and I know .NET also, you know, I have certain level of expertise in these technologies. So what I did is that I hire a guy, a junior guy, I ask him, you know, the work of that guy is just to write articles. You know, I pay him, he comes in the morning, write articles on my name, and he leaves in the evening, I pay him in return. So for the world view, I am the one who is writing articles, right? So can a person, you know, Can a person cheat in that sense?
It's unethical, you should not do it.
No, it's unethical, I'm saying. But I'm saying that, you know, are there people who kind of do that just to get an MVP?
Not in my knowledge, but if people are doing it, it is not right.
Mm-hmm. So basically, you know, why I'm asking this question is that if a professional sees a lot of value in it, right, that value can be tangible value or non-tangible value, right? Then they may tend to get the award by hook or crook, right? So if I see a value in being a Microsoft MVP, then and the criteria is that you should be writing articles, then someone may think that, you know, I can go this route, right? So is there a downside? Is there an upside? You know, can you still be an MVP or will you just not get
this question?
So I'm not saying that, you know, someone should plan it like this.
But
and
we are doing it. See, I can. Like most of the benefits of Microsoft MVP programs
mm-hmm.
are highly technical benefits.
Right. And they're not tangible benefits.
They're not like interaction productive.
Right, right.
So for example, if I'm a consultant,
mm-hmm.
I'm a consultant and like I want to know that whether this feature is coming in next 3 months or not.
Mm-hmm.
Right? So that I can consult to my client.
Right, right, right.
This type of advantage you get here.
Mm-hmm.
Now if I'm a non-technical person,
then
even
you
if you have become
then
maybe
not.
For a year you can carry that tag and have a Microsoft MVP, but it is not going to help you.
Right. So what you are saying is that if I rephrase it, even if you become an MVP, it will not help you because knowledge is something that that you will get in return. Networking is something that you will get in return, which will not benefit you if you do not have that capacity to consume them.
You
will
feel opt out when you go
you,
to a you will go to a room.
Right.
So when
right.
there is a let us say event
mm-hmm.
only for MVPs by Microsoft,
right,
there
right.
is like high end technical.
Right.
Events, right? So
right.
you should left out.
Right. So that's a good thing, right? Plus, it will not even help you in interviews or getting a job.
Yes.
Right? And there are no back.
MVP is anything not for getting.
Not for job. And there are no monetary benefits attached to it.
There's exactly. no direct monetary.
Direct. Benefit. Yeah, direct.
But you get like Microsoft licenses free of cost.
Yeah.
You get to attend MVP summit and
yeah.
then the country level MVP open days. So there are benefits.
Yeah.
And of course, like if you are independent consulting or an independent trainer, you
mm-hmm.
can increase your rate.
right.
On basis of that, right? Maybe not in India, but wherever, whoever knows it, you can ask for them, there are benefits.
Mm-hmm.
Because you are, again, that independent expert who has real-time answers.
But it can backfire also, in that sense, you know. You are overexposing yourself, you do not have the capacity, so you are overexposing yourself. So maybe you will get short-term benefits, but that may harm you a lot.
So you need to have that check and balance for yourself.
Right.
That if you are charging $100 per hour, whether maybe you can get that business for 1 hour,
right.
But what you get for a second hour?
The repeat value will not be there. Alright, so that's a great thing, you know. So probably the next question is that whom will you recommend to explicitly prepare themselves for MBB?
Okay, so my question nowadays I see among young college pass out students, like they plan for MBB.
Right.
And that is not right.
That is not right.
You just do your stuff if you like to do that.
Right. So it is a byproduct. It has to be a byproduct. If you are planning for it, then probably it is not.
No one creates Ruby to get Oscar.
Right. Getting award is a byproduct.
Yes.
So
if you enjoy doing it, right? Like for example, if I don't write articles, if I don't write articles for a week, I don't feel good.
Mm-hmm.
And that's why that's the motivation. That is the motivation which is helping me to write articles for the last 10 years.
Right.
If it was only attached to an award, I would have left writing only got it one time or two times, right? So that instinct should be there. Like I know a few of MVPs, I mean, if they don't answer questions on the Stack Workflow, they don't feel like sleeping.
Right. So they feel that, you know, they have not done something in the day.
Yes.
It is like, you know, you somehow have not just gone out of that for the day. Right? So it is like intellectually going out.
Yes.
Right? So,
it is like, so I say that MVP is like a journalism. Right? You do your reporting.
Right.
Someone will recognize your journalism.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So alright. So basically at the end, you know, what advice would you like to give to young professionals? For example, you know, if I am a professional and I become an MVP next year, then there is some amount of energy, some amount of time that will go into this effort. Right. So will you recommend those professionals? So what is your advice for the people who are looking for becoming an MVP? And what are the other communities also? You know, there are other communities which get MVP awards also. Right? So just your last word of advice to everyone.
Okay, so very first, it is good to have Microsoft MVP award. It definitely helps.
Right.
But don't plan for it. Just let it come.
Mm-hmm.
Right? And it is always good feeling if you are helping people. And if you are really planning it, then it should be a combination of everything.
Mm-hmm.
Write articles,
mm-hmm.
do social media,
right.
Like do social media about your articles,
mm-hmm.
answer questions on
mm-hmm.
Stack Workflow.
Mm-hmm.
You should have a really solid GitHub profile where you have submitted, you know,
uploaded
codes.
Mm-hmm.
And best is that if you can write a book.
So at the end, I'll be sharing the Twitter handle and social media handle of Dhananjay if you want to directly contact him, and if you have any further queries about MVP. Dhananjay, so thank you so much for your time.
Thank you.
I really appreciate it. I know you are a friend, and you know, saying thanks to friend is normally, you know, we are hesitant to say thanks to friend, but I really appreciate it and thank you.
Thank you so much, and I hope it helps. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you.